रिस्टोरेशन ड्रामा, व्हेन वी से रिस्टोरेशन ड्रामा इट मींस ड्रामा ऑफ रिस्टोरेशन एज, एंड दैट एज बिसाइड्स अदर थिंग्स दैट्स द रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ थिएटर दैट वाज बैंड इन इंग्लैंड फ्रॉम 1642 टू 1660 मीन द टाइम व्हेन प्यूरिटन वर very much powerful in England and they banned theater. After restoration of monarchy, theater was also restored. So when we say restoration or theater, that means theater that was restored after restoration of monarchy. In that period, we see a significant change in drama. First, patent theater or licensed theater. That's a new trend in theater's history. Second, appearance of female actors on stage for performance of female roles. Third, there is not a continuity of Renaissance drama, particularly Elizabethan and Jacobean drama of University of Wits and Shakespeare, or even drama of Ben Jonson. Here is new type of drama which is known for the audience taste for comedy. That's significantly comedies. And comedies are introduced in three ways. First, restoration comedy, second, sentimental comedy, and third, comedy of manners. So, after restoration, we see there were two licensed or patent theaters, the Theatre Royal. That was in Drury Lane, so that is called Drury Lane Theatre. And other is Duke's House at Lincoln's Inn, that later on moved to Covent Garden Theatre in 1732. So two licensed or patent theatres were Theatre Royal of Drury Lane and Duke's House at Lincoln's Inn. The actresses began to appear on stage, and the first actress was Mrs. Coleman, who appeared in a private performance of Sir William D'Avenant's The Siege of Rhodes in 1656. Definitely, that's a time before a restoration of monarchy and theater, but that was a private performance in which she appeared. Afterwards, when it was publicly opened, King Charles II's wife actually appeared in a theatrical performance. When the ban on theater was lifted, there was a world of theater that was in support of classical canons, that was in support of audience taste and commercialization of theater. Under the influence of classical canons and classical standards, writers tried to modify Renaissance drama. Its one example is Nahum Tate, who was also one of the poet laureates. Nahum Tate adapted King Lear on classical standards. Adding prologue to the play, developing a plot of love between Edgar and Cordelia, and then adding a sense of poetic justice to the play. So, likewise, Dr. Faustus, that was a play by Christopher Marlowe, that was adapted to Restoration stage as a farcical drama instead of tragedy. Restoration tragedy was also written, but that was not so significant. John Dryden, dominant poet, dramatist, and great prose writer of the time, he wrote heroic tragedy that is, you can say, representative of Restoration tragedy, though Restoration tragedy was quite a failure as compared to Renaissance tragedy. Renaissance tragedy, jitni zyada jo hai wo apne grandeur ki wajah se jani jati hai, especially Shakespeare, to Restoration mein tragedy ko koi worth hasil nahi thi aur ye ek failed experience ki tarah treat kiya jata. Second, it was not a tragedy of ambition, it was more the tragedy of suffering. On one side, John Dryden wrote heroic tragedy like All for Love, and later on, Thomas Otway, another tragedian of the time, he wrote The Orphan and The Venice Preserved. The Orphan and The Venice Preserved, that are thought the representative tragedies of Restoration age, they were not actually the tragedy of ambition where heroes, you can say, ambition and actions get attention. Rather, here hero is hero because he tries to be a conformist. So, ye tragedies jo hain wo Renaissance ki spirit ke khilaf thi. और इनमें जो है वो एक सोसाइटी के साथ जो है हम आहंग इंसान को जो है उसको एक ट्रेजिक हीरो के तौर पर पेश किया था. As I have mentioned, tragedy was not the dominant genre of the time, though Dryden and Otway tried it, and even George Lillo's play, The London Merchant, that is, by the way, performed in both way as a comedy or as a domestic tragedy. So if we treat it as a domestic tragedy, that's a play which gets, you can say, public attention as well as much appreciation as compared to other dramatists. Restoration drama is better known for comedies, and it is called comedy of manners. Even in English literature, comedy of manner has developed as an independent genre. Baz universities ke syllabus mein, BS program mein, comedy of manners ka paper introduce karaya jata hai, aur usme wo comedy of manners mein kabhi George Farquhar, kabhi William Congreve, और उसके बाद शेरिडन या गोल्डस्मिथ, उसके बाद ऑस्कर वाइल्ड और जॉर्ज बर्नार्ड शॉ, इन ड्रामाटिस्ट के प्लेस को आम तौर पर कॉमेडी ऑफ मैनर्स के कोर्स में इंक्लूड किया जाता है. तो ये एसेंस है इस योनरा का जो इस तरह की कोर्स आउटलाइन में रिफ्लेक्ट होता है. Restoration comedy was called the comedy of manner because it mirrored directly the manners, modes, and morals of the upper class. And main subject of Restoration comedy was sex, sexual attraction, sexual intrigue, sexual conquest, and affectation and manners of the people who are trying to get attention of the opposite sex. Mostly, you can say the young widows, and there were hedonist aristocrats. That drama was, on one side, that was amusement for public. That was realistic portrayal of contemporary society. And it was a criticism on the manners and living of the people, especially the upper class people. But there was also a protest against that drama, that this drama is amoral. This drama is frivolous. And these comedies are, you can say in a loose sense of the word, vulgar. Is drama ke jahan jo hai appreciation ho rahi thi, wahan iske khilaf ek jo hai protest bhi chal raha tha, jo baad mein Jeremy Collier के प्रोटेस्ट के बाद एक मूवमेंट की सूरत अख्तियार करता है. When we use the term the restoration comedy, mostly it are in strict sense five dramatists and their plays. The restoration comedy, when it is used in satiric sense, it stands for the dramas of dramas of William Wycherly, George Etheridge, Van Bro, George Farquhar, and William Congreve. These five dramatists represent, you can say, the restoration comedy. And then there is a time of sentimental comedy, which Richard Steele is the most important dramatist of that genre. And then we see comedy of manners. There were also female dramatists, and Aphra Behn, who was poet, dramatist, novelist of the time, she has been rediscovered in 20th century, and her place has been recognized as a dramatist as well. She wrote her drama The Rover, that is an example of comedy of action. Or her drama is called The Comedy of Action, as it is contrasted with The Comedy of Character, that was written by George Etheridge. George Etheridge's best play is The Man of Mode, and another play of George Etheridge is called The Comical Revenge. And purpose was just to satirize the contemporary society. William Wycherly, known for his play The Country Wife, that play is introduced as comedy of seduction and hypocrisy. And even the name of characters are very much, you can say, satirical and cunning, like Mr. Horner, who is protagonist and Mrs. Pinch wife. Weikel's work was thought, you can say, more obscene at that time, and that was one of the reason that later on, you can say, it caused a reaction of Jeremy Collier. Jeremy Collier, he was a priest, and he wrote a pamphlet, Short View of the Immorality and Profaneness of the English Stage. Collier complained about mockery of the clergy, profanity and bad language, topics already aired in Puritan strictures against the theater, and there was an advocacy for legislation and you can say censorship upon theater. Immediate result of that pamphlet was a royal order prohibiting the acting on anything contrary to religion and good manners. Jab ye pamphlet zahir hai ke phailaya gaya to isko iske supporter to pehle se kuch maujood the, to ek samjha gaya ke ye ek political step jo hai hona chahiye, aur political step ye uthaya gaya ke ek order जारी किया गया कि कोई ऐसा ड्रामा जो मजहब के खिलाफ हो और गुड मैनर्स के खिलाफ हो उसे ऑन जो है वो स्टेज ना किया जाए। लेकिन 1737 में एक्चुअल जो है वो लाइसेंस एक्ट जो है वो इंट्रोड्यूस कराया जाता है, जिसके पीछे यही कंपेन थी जो जेरेमी कोलियर ने इनिशिएट की। On one side, that was, you can say, campaign against restoration comedy. On the other side, the dramatists like William Congreve, Sir John Vanbrugh, or George Farquhar, they are even thought the better than the previous two, Wycherly and Etheridge. In universities, mostly William Congreve's play, The Way of the World, is introduced and recommended. Sometimes George Farquhar, the recruiting officer, is taught. Both Congreve and Farquhar, they were Irish. And William Congreve, his three comedies were performed in 1690s, The Old Bachelor, The Double Dealer, Love for Love. And in 1700, he presented his masterpiece, that The Way of the World. And The Way of the World, that's, you can say, intrigues of the upper class, where the characters like Millamant try to play with a rich lady and make her fool. Congreve, what raises Congreve above many of his contemporaries is the observation of the social and emotional pressures on characters. So observation and presentation of character, that is you can say trait of Congreve's drama. And Congreve is much appreciated for that is called Comedy of Manners, or Beginning of Comedy of Manners. Vanbrugh, he wrote The Relapse and The Provoked Wife. These were the dramas which were thought also a reason for Jeremy Collier's hostile reaction and his pamphlet. Vanbrugh was a dramatist who you can say, provoked many, you can say, opponents through his bitter or sarcastic realism. Farquharson, the recruiting officer, reminds us that at this time the country was at war, and the war of the Spanish Succession involved considerable English army losses on the continent. His other play, The Buick Stratagem, presents the stratagem or technique of Captain Plume and his sergeant Kite to catch a rich wife. Both are examples of comedy of manners, and they represent the Restoration themes and plot devices. Farquhar's plays, it is thought, they explore comedy of human motivation in a new context. Likewise, there were plays of Susanna Centlivre. They were presented in around 1700s. A bold stroke for a wife is particularly memorable, combining the battle of the sexes with witty satire on religious narrow-mindedness. Between 1707 and 1737, drama went into critical decline. Although the theater was still very active and popular, decline was partly due to opposition from Jeremy Collier and others, and partly because the middle classes were turning to journals, newspapers, and developing new genres of fictional prose. So instead of watching performers in theater, they preferred to read, you can say, magazines, periodicals, and novels. There is another significant play, that's farce and musical plays like The Beggar's Opera by John Gay. John Gay's The Beggar's Opera achieved lasting popular success that was produced in 1728. We can say, from 1707 to 1737, that's probably the only memorable play. John Gay mixes ballads, songs, vivid character in the city comedy tradition. City comedy tradition was popular in the time of Ben Jonson. Ben Jonson is one of the important writer of city comedy. Burlesque parody of Italian opera and some sentimental scenes, and more than a touch of political satire to create a highly original piece of theater. It was the political satire that you can say encouraged the Whig Prime Minister Sir Robert Walpole to introduce the Theatre Licensing Act of 1737. The Theatre's Licensing Act of 1737 introduced censorship in the person of the Lord Chamberlain, who could grant or refuse a license to any play on political, religious, or moral grounds. So Jeremy Collier ne jo campaign shuru ki thi 1698 mein, अब वो कंपेन जो है वो बाकायदा से एक एक्ट की सूरत अख्तियार करती है, जब विग पार्टी के प्राइम मिनिस्टर सर रॉबर्ट वॉलपोल, जो कि एक तरफ तो द बैगर्स ओपरा के सेट्रिकल अटैक से काफी परेशान थे, और दूसरी तरफ हेनरी फील्डिंग, जिसको हम नॉवलिस्ट के तौर पर जानते हैं, उसके हिस्टोरिकल रजिस्टर फॉर 1736 प्ले से भी तंग थे, उन्होंने ये एक्ट जो है वो इंट्रोड्यूस कराया, और एक लॉर्ड चैम्बरलेन को ये पार्स डेलीगेट की कि वो किसी प्ले को की परफॉर्मेंस को मना कर सकते हैं, रिफ्यूज कर सकते हैं अगर उसमें कोई पॉलिटिकल, रिलीजियस या मॉरल जो है वो इंडिसेंसी है। तो मॉरल इंडिसेंसी, रिलीजियस इंडिसेंसी, पॉलिटिकल इंडिसेंसी, हम समझ सकते हैं कि ये हमेशा से कुछ इस तरह के मामलात रहे हैं कि इसमें कुछ भी फिर शामिल हो सकता है। जब इस तरह की कोई सेंसरशिप आती है तो किस किस तरह से, किस किस किस्म के वर्क्स जो हैं उनको सेंसर कर दिया जाता है। तो ये ड्रामा का वो फर्स्ट फेज है जिसमें असल में तो 1700 तक या 1707 तक जो रिस्टोरेशन कॉमेडी के जो पांच बड़े ड्रामाटिस्ट हैं उनके वर्क सामने आते हैं। उनके अलावा जॉन ड्राइडन, ऑटवे, ओपरा बहन, वो अपने स्टाइल से जो है वो ड्रामा लिखते हैं। खास तौर पर ओपरा बहन का जो ड्रामा है द रोवर, वो एक कॉमेडी ऑफ एक्शन है और ये इसको जो है वो ट्रेडिशन से जरा हट के जो है वो देखा जाता है। इसी तरह द लंडन मर्चेंट और थ्री बैगर्स ओपरा, ये भी जो है वो ड्रामास सिग्निफिकेंट है अपने जमाने के। अब 1737 के बाद ड्रामा में क्या प्रेजेंट किया जाता है, ये कह सकते हैं कि अनलाइटनमेंट एज या रिस्टोरेशन एज का लास्ट पार्ट है। यहां पर जो है दो बड़े ड्रामाटिस्ट RWB शेरिडन और ओलिवर गोल्डस्मिथ जो है वो मौजूद हैं। हिस्ट्री ऑफ 18th सेंचुरी थिएटर बिकम्स द हिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्टर्स रादर देन ऑफ प्लेस। ऑल्दो मोस्ट ऑफ द लिटरेरी फिगर्स ऑफ द टाइम डिड ट्राई राइटिंग फॉर द थिएटर एट वन टाइम और एन अदर। डॉक्टर जॉनसन, ये हेयर सैमुअल जॉनसन, ही रोट अ ट्रेजेडी इरीन, रैन फॉर 9 परफॉर्मेंसेस इन 1749 एंड रिचर्ड स्टील्स हु हैज यू कैन से फेम ऑफ हिज जर्नल स्पेक्टेटर लेफ्ट अ हेरिटेज ऑफ सेंटिमेंटल कॉमेडीज विच हेल्ड द स्टेज फॉर मोर देन 60 ईयर्स आफ्टर हिज डेथ इन 1729। Richard Steele, he was the most important writer of comedy, sentimental comedy. Now there was turn of Oliver Goldsmith and Richard Brinsley Sheridan. These two dramatists like Farquhar and Congreve, they were Irish. And later on, we see two other Irish dramatists, Oscar Wilde and George Bernard Shaw. So you can also trace some links of